Okay, welcome back to the students. Good evening, my dear students. Today in my class, today I am going to teach you commutative law. In the previous class, I had taught you what closure law. Today I am going to teach you commutative law. So first of all, we will discuss you what is commutative law of addition. Okay, let us start. The commutative law of addition says that when two numbers, two commutative laws, when two whole numbers, when two whole numbers, when two whole numbers undergoes undergo what addition in any order, its value always remains same. It means value does not change. Okay, it means if I'll tell you a plus b is equal to b plus a, if a and b are two whole numbers, then a plus b is equal to b plus. Okay, let us see the when two whole numbers undergo addition in any order, its value always remains same. Okay, this is called commutative law of what? Addition. This is called, I have to write here, this is called commutative law what? Commutative of, you should open the mouth. Okay, this is called commutative law of what? Addition. It means a plus b is equal to what? B plus. For example, you see here, a plus b is equal to b plus a. A plus b, this is the equal sign. A plus b is written in LHS. LHS means what? Left hand side. So left hand side written what? A plus b. Right hand side what written?
B plus a.
B plus a. Okay, loudly say
b plus a.
So you have to prove that a plus b is equal to b plus a. Okay, for example, suppose I will prove 2 plus 3 is equal to how much?
6.
3 plus
5.
2. I will prove it.
3 plus.
Suppose you see LHS left hand side. LHS left hand side. What is the left hand side? 2
plus 3.
What is 2 plus 3?
3 plus 2.
What is the value of 2 plus 3?
5.
Here first is written, what is the first number?
2.
Achha. What is the second number?
3.
I have written first 2, then I am going to add 3. So 2 plus 3, 5. That's a right hand side. RHS. What is right hand side?
3 plus 2.
What is 3 plus 2?
5.
So here in 3 plus 2, what is the first number?
3.
So you see in the LHS, what is the first number?
2.
What is the second number?
3.
So in the RHS, what is the first number?
3.
Means in RHS I have written first 3, then 2. It means I have changed the order of the number. Here I have written in the LHS 2 first, then 3. But here first number in the RHS, first I have written, first number is
3.
And second number is
2.
What you are observing here in LHS and RHS? Here first number is 2. Here first number is
2.
Here first number is
3.
Here second number is
3.
Here second number is
2.
It means the order of the number I have changed. I have changed the order of the number. So by changing the order of the number, if I am adding the two number by changing their order, the value is remain what?
Same.
Understand? So first I am writing adding 2 plus 3, which is equal to 5. By changing the order in the RHS, 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. Hence 3 plus 2. So 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, 3 plus 2 is equal to
5.
What are you observing? If I am adding 2 plus 3, what is the value? The same will come 3 plus 2 or not? Same value will come or not? So this is called what? Commutative law of
addition.
Commutative law of addition. Okay. Understood or not? Achha. Similarly, another example I can say. You see 4 plus 5, how much? Is equal to?
9.
Achha, 5 plus 4?
Is 9.
9. Hence, what are we observing here? 4 plus 5 is equal to? 5 plus 4. Okay. I am using same number. But here what I am doing? I am adding by changing changing their what? Order. Understand? So, if the two number undergoes addition in any order, by changing their order, their value will remain same. Okay. And this is called commutative law of what?
Addition.
Is it clear? Okay. So, similarly, if A and B are two whole number, then A plus B is equal to how much? B plus A.
B plus.
X plus Y is equal to how much?
Y plus X.
Y plus X. M plus N is equal to how much? N plus M. Is it clear?
Yes.
So this is about the commutative law of addition. The second bit I am going to discuss, commutative law of what? Multiplication. First multiplication. Commutative law
of multiplication.
Of multiplication. Commutative law of
multiplication.
Understand or not? So similarly, same is in the you written here. The when the commutative addition, you see when the two number undergoes addition in any order, its value remains same. It means addition obeys commutative law. Similarly, in case of multiplication, only just you can write also when the two number undergoes in place of addition your multiplication in any order, its value remain same. This is called commutative law of multiplication. Write down when when the two whole numbers we are studying commutative properties of whole numbers. Okay. When two whole numbers undergo addition in any
multiplication
in any order, its value remains remains same. Okay, this is called
commutative law of
multiplication. It means the multiplication obeys commutative law for the whole number. Once again, repeat, when two whole numbers undergo multiplication in any order, its value remains same. This is called commutative law of multiplication. Okay. It means A into B is equal to what?
B into A.
A. X into Y is equal to what?
Y into X.
Understand? If A and B are the two whole numbers, then A into B is equal to B into A. Similarly, if X and Y are two whole numbers, then X into Y is equal to what? Y into X. Okay. For example, you see. Example 1. You multiply 2 into 3. Take a very small number. 2 into 3 how much?
6.
2, 3 is 6. First time writing here 2, then 3.
3.
Okay, first number is 2. As a first, then first I will change the order. Change the order means first I will which number?
3.
3. Then which number?
2.
2. Okay. So 3 into 2, 3 to ja?
6.
6. Understand? So what are observing here? Hence 2 into 3 is equal to what? 3 into 2. 2. Understood or not?
Yes.
Similarly, 4 into 5 is equal to?
5.
Say, 4 into 5 is equal to?
20.
Is equal to 20? Then similarly, 5 into 4? 20. Understood or not?
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, 3 into 4 is equal to? 4 into?
3.
Understand? Okay. Similarly, 6 into 5. What is 6
5?
5
is 30.
Similarly, 5 into 6. What is 5 6?
30.
So, this is always commutative law. Plus multiplication always commutative law. Understood or not? When the two, let us repeat again, when two whole numbers undergo multiplication in any order, its value remains same. This is called commutative law of multiplication. A into B is equal to?
B into A.
Okay. As X into Y is equal to?
Y into X.
So let us see, 2 into 3, 2 3 ja?
6.
As 3 into 2, 3 2 ja?
6.
So 2 into 3 is equal to?
3 into 2.
So this is called commutative law of multiplication. This is how multiplication always commutative law. Okay. So let's we'll discuss the commutative law of subtraction. Do you think subtraction always commutative law?
No.
Let us see. Commutative law of subtraction. Commutative law of subtraction. Subtraction does not obey commutative law. Okay. It means when for the whole number, when two whole numbers undergo subtraction. When two whole number undergo subtraction, its value will not same. Value will, its value does not remain same. Its value does not
remain same.
Different. Value will be different. Yes. Thus, this subtraction.
Subtraction does not obey.
Commutative law.
For the whole numbers.
Understand or not? Let us see. Here you see 7 minus 3 how much? 7 minus 3 is equal to how much?
4.
You see 7 minus 3. I told 7 is a positive number plus 7.
Mm-hmm.
3 is a negative number.
Yes.
7 minus 3 how much?
4.
4. Others, which is bigger number?
7.
Which sign does it carry?
Plus 7.
So the result is what?
4 plus 4.
Plus 4 means what? 4.
4.
Similarly, 3 minus 7?
Minus 4.
Do you remember? It means that implies what you observe. Are they same?
No.
7 minus 3 is? 7 minus 3 is?
Not
6. Are what is 7 minus 3?
4.
See, no. 3 minus 7?
Minus 4.
Are the same?
No.
4 is a positive number, positive integer. Minus 4 is a negative integer. So they are not same. So 7 minus 3 is not equal to 3 minus 7. Understand?
Yes.
Hence, thus, Thus, it proves that the subtraction
does not obey
commutative law
for subtraction
for whole number. We're discussing whole number, huh?
Yes.
Whole numbers. Understand or not?
Yes.
So similarly, can you say 9 minus 5 is not equal to what is
5 minus 9?
As I see LHS, left hand side, 9 minus 5 is equal to how much?
4.
Achha, RHS, 5 9 is how much?
Minus 4.
Hence, 9 minus 5, 9 minus 5 is not equal to?
Not equal to 5 minus 9.
Minus 9. Okay. So similarly, again, you see now, 7 minus 3 how much? 7 minus, suppose 5, 7 minus 5?
2.
5 minus 7?
Minus 2.
Hence, 7 minus 5 is not equal to 5 minus 7. Understand or not? No, minus 2 is not a whole number. Because whole numbers means what? 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. They are whole number. Minus 2 does not belong to whole number. Minus 2 is not a number. Hello? Does not belong to in the set of whole number. Understand? It only belongs to integer. We are talking about the whole numbers, properties of whole numbers. Similarly, 10 minus 6 how much? 10 minus 6?
4.
4. Okay, 6 minus 10?
Minus 4.
Minus 4. Hence, are they same?
No.
So, 10 minus 6 is not equal to?
6 minus 10.
This is clear?
Yes.
About the commutative law of subtraction. So, you do understand what you understood? The subtraction obeys commutative law?
No.
Then what does? Does not obey commutative law for the whole numbers. Understand? And always remember commutative law useful only for the two numbers. Not for? When you are using two numbers, we use which law? Commutative law. Then next, come to the point D. Commutative law of division. So do you think commutative division does not obey commutative law? Does it obey?
No, it doesn't.
Commutative law of division.
Division.
Division does not obey commutative law.
No.
You see now, when two whole numbers undergo
division,
yes, in any order, then its value
remains,
its value does not remain same, its value
does not remain same,
its value will be different. Thus, like subtraction, division also does not obey.
Division does not obey.
Commutative law for the whole number. For the
whole numbers.
For the
whole numbers.
See, again, when two whole numbers undergo division in any order, its value does not remain same, its value will be different, thus the division does not obey commutative law. It means A divided by B is not equal to B divided by
A.
X divided by Y is not equal to
Y divided by X.
m divided by n is not equal to
m divided by n.
M. For example, you see 12 divided by 4, how much?
3.
Achha. 4 divided by 12, how much? Means 4 divided by 12, 4 upon 12 I can write.
Yes.
So can you cancel 4 1 the 4 3 how much?
1 by 3.
So you see, what is 12 divided by 4?
3.
What is 4 divided by 12?
1 by 3.
So are they same?
No.
Hence 12 divided by 4 is not equal to 4 divided by 12. Yes. Thus the division does not obey
commutative law.
Hello. Thus it proves that the division does not obey commutative
law.
For whole numbers. Okay. Other similarly, tell me 15 divided by 3. How much?
5.
Other 3 divided by 15. 3 upon 15. Fraction. 3 1 jai, 3 3 5 jai. 1 upon
5.
So 3 upon 3 divided by 15 is equal to how much?
5.
1 upon 5, 3 divided by 15
five.
Is equal to
1 upon 5.
Lovely, sir. Okay. Okay. Since what you understood, 15 divided by 3 is not equal to 3 divided by 15. So 15 divided by 3 is not equal to 3 divided by 15. So this is clear that division also does not obey commutative law for the whole numbers. So understood commutative law?
Yes.
In this commutative law, so what you understood? First of all, addition and multiplication obeys
commutative law.
Commutative law. Subtraction and division obey
does not
obey commutative law for the
whole numbers.
Whole numbers.